parents. First, reinvent early education. There are powerful economic arguments about investing in early education. Jim Heckman and others have found that a $6,700 investment in quality pre-K for at-risk children yields a $70,000 return on investment over the life of the child. It improves outcomes for long-term educational achievement, home ownership, and salary, while reducing negative behaviors like substance abuse and crime. But are the early education models invented 40 years ago evolving at the pace we need to change children's lives today? Are the models using technology as a tool for discovery and invention? Are the staff and the environments designed and developed for productivity and for personal attention? Can overstressed parents who are dealing with an economy that asks for more effort to make ends meet effectively track and contribute to children's progress? Are the skills being taught internationally benchmarked? The short answer, not yet. This is why we are looking at the role Sesame Street can play in recharging early education. Sesame Street is an educational brand that three generations of viewers are familiar with. Believe it or not, we've produced over 4,000 hours of curriculum-based content that can be used to reinforce lessons of all kinds, from literacy, health, and social, emotional skills to math and science skills, not just at home, but now in the classroom. We can help that preschool teacher in Dallas or New Orleans reinforce her lesson on geometric shapes with compelling video about Telly's love for triangles, or help connect the home school environment through mobile messages to parents about what their child is learning and how that learning can continue at home, in the car, or at the neighborhood grocery store. Today, Julio learned about the letter C. Point out things that start with the letter C. C is for clock, C is for cat, cauliflower, cantaloupe. Or provide the individualized learning that a struggling child might need to help Julio build knowledge and confidence at his own pace. Learning never stops. It is 24/7 and must encompass the whole child. We have an opportunity to really build a system that looks holistically at education, connecting the home and school to create a preschool for the 21st century. Second, the quality of the content matters. We know kids are using media more and more effectively every day. And while their media choices continue to expand, sometimes more is just more. There's a real lack of quality educational content available for elementary children, especially those in grades K through 3. It's a bit of going from Sesame Street to all SpongeBob all the time. And an analysis of nearly 300 interactive media projects for preschool and elementary age kids by the Cooney Center found only two products out of 300 were based on an explicit educational curriculum that were available in the market. We need more. We need to know how this content is impacting children's learning. Without quality educational content, technology is just a neutral medium. It is dumb. It is the content that gives way to learning. It is the content that makes such a technology a valuable partner for individualized learning, both inside and outside the classroom. Take the electric company. We actually brought it back recently, some of you may remember the earlier shows, to provide a 360-degree literacy experience for 6 to 9-year-olds using television, the internet, mobile devices, video games, print materials, after-school programs, community resource programs. It was created to hit the crucial time in literacy when children transition from learning to read to reading to learn, as Reba mentioned before. Here's a little clip of the show with a very famous guy named LL Cool J. You'll see what this, talking about punctuation.
Punctuation, mark, punctuation, mark, punctuation, mark, punctuation. When you see a punctuation mark, yeah, you have to know what to do.
a period, comma, question mark, and an exclamation point too. They're in every sentence that you read or write. Take a look, it's true. So when you see a punctuation mark, you have to know what to do. A period shows that a sentence is over. I can fly a plane. A question mark shows you're asking a question. Can you fly a plane? An exclamation point expresses excitement. Hey, watch out for that plane. A comma means you slow down, pause, take a breath. When I wanna go to Spain, I hop onto my plane. When you see a punctuation mark, you have to know what to do. A period, comma, question mark, and an exclamation point too. They're in every sentence that you read or write. Take a look, it's true. So when you see a punctuation mark, you have to know what to do.
The rules of punctuation taught in new ways. What we've found is that kids are showing significant literacy gains from this show, especially when our content is embedded in a robust early learning intervention program for struggling readers. Kids are learning from just one segment. Imagine what an entire library of content could do. In fact, what we're now creating is a complete phonics genome collection. So teachers can illustrate each or all of the 126 phonemic rules in the English language. The silent E and the CH sound, we have to tap into this potential. Third, train teachers to use technology. When I think about teachers today, I think about Jennifer Ward, who we visited at Kilpatrick Elementary School in Nashville, Tennessee, a school in the shadow of Titans Stadium in an African immigrant neighborhood, actually. In her class of low-income preschoolers, she uses a slide projector hooked up to a computer to show video clips that support her lessons. These short videos open up her students to a larger world. They also open up possibilities of how she teaches her students, and she is doing it with some good success. But think what Jennifer could achieve with catalog lesson plans tied directly to digital content illustrations. Of course, we can talk all day about how great technology is in the classroom, how it holds unlimited potential for learning, but if we don't train and support our teachers, it will be just another gimmick with low return. Teachers, especially young teachers, are increasingly receptive to the possibilities media hold as a learning device. In fact, 3/4 are already using some form of digital media in the classroom. We expect these numbers to only rise as more graduates enter the classroom, out of colleges and teaching colleges, themselves digital natives. Now, we have to make sure that behind every teacher is a solid professional development program to maximize the arsenal of content they can now have at their disposal. Fourth, we have to engage parents, children's first teachers, in a much more thoroughly modern and systematic way. A few years ago, with the assistance of a research team at WestEd Labs, we developed a pilot study in Oakland, California, looking at how cell phones could be used to encourage children's emergent literacy skills. Parents who participated in this agreed to take a cell phone and a call from Sesame Street's Maria each day, introducing a new letter of the alphabet every day. After the call, they were asked to hand the cell phone to their child, who would then see a short video message about that letter from Elmo. At the conclusion of the study, nearly 80% of lower-income parents said that this interaction really helped improve their child's knowledge of the alphabet. Just as importantly, parents felt connected to their child's learning. Now, this is a crude test, and it was a crude test. But in 1 month using a cell phone, kids learned the alphabet in Oakland, California. Finally, we must forge unpredictable alliances to innovate. You know the African proverb, or maybe it was the Tea Party, I'm not sure, that says, if you want to go fast, go alone. If you want to go far, go together. In this revolution, we will need to unite our own expertise to create a new style of learning for the 21st century. It will fuse unlikely partners to create content and resources that work inside and outside the classroom. Simply put, the sum of the whole will be much larger than the individual parts, so we must work together. Now, everyone in this room is already working hard to tackle the challenges of education. And I, for one, stand here humbled in front of you and the work that you're doing around the country. Literacy, early childhood, STEM education, high school dropout rates, small schools, big schools. You're all here in New Orleans because of that commitment to build solutions. You are the action leaders that can invest and convene allies from contrasting sectors to seed new ideas and scale proven ones. And by the way, promote and push and prod political leaders who are increasingly incapable of driving dramatic structural changes. Just as we faced at the end of World War II and at the declaration of the war on poverty, we are at a crossroads in education in 2010. We can shape the kind of transformational change we want to see in our education system, or maintain the status quo that is pushing this nation further down the global economic ladder. The message goes much farther than educating a child. This is about educating a nation on how and why we must start education early, all the while igniting children's passion and enthusiasm for learning through lessons that meet children on their own turf through the common bond of technology, teamed up with great teaching and a new digital trend to the connected parent. If I leave you with one thought today, it is not to not underestimate the power of technology in education and the vitality and sense of fervor it can bring when looking through the lens of 21st century learning. Technology can help build and create innovative linkages in education, employing new ways for how we prepare that low-income preschooler in Oakland to succeed in school, or help that teacher in Nashville challenge and motivate a clever, tech-savvy, yet struggling third grader reach reading proficiency, or inspire that high school student in Detroit so when he is handed that diploma, he is positive and motivated about his future, and our nation is the better for it. This is the kind of solution and the kind of future we want for all of our children. There really is no room for failure at this level of the game. The stakes are just too high. For how we move the education agenda forward today not only impacts the life of a child, it impacts the trajectory of a nation. This is our legacy. Thank you for having me here today.